dream come true moment for me, and I want to relish each and every moment I'm sitting here with you.
Thank you so much.
Yep, like you said in the morning, I had the privilege of having breakfast with ma'am today, and we were discussing that it's an integral part of Tamil Brahmin family to learn music, Veena and Bharatanatyam. So can I request you to please sing two lines for us?
Oh my God, first let me talk to you, talk to everybody before I shock them with a song. Anyway, they've been listening to a beautiful singing by you. So let's give them some breather, okay?
Okay. You've been one of the legends of South Indian cinema. You started your career as makeup artist. You got into...
That's wrong. Sorry.
Wrong?
I started as a cinematographer, as a photographer.
Photographer.
Yeah, so thanks to Wikipedia.
Okay. So you have pretty much received awards in all the South Indian languages for your roles. You have been into direction. Now you also take care of your Madras talkies.
Yes.
Yeah. So which is the role which is most satisfying for you?
I don't know if any role is going to satisfy you, you're not going to be looking for another role, isn't it? So no role is really satisfying. You feel happy about things that work out in a role that you're playing. So
yeah.
I think the most difficult role is being a wife and a mother. And it's never satisfying. You're playing it from the beginning till end of your life, but still it's not satisfying. They don't give you any awards.
I'm in awe of your smile. You know, I can't take off my eyes. Okay. So, you were so beautiful. I mean, you're beautiful more now. But those days, Vishnuvardhan fell in love with you in Bandhana, and he went into depression because he could not marry you. He killed himself. And later on,
I know.
Ramesh,
why did you leave married men also?
No.
They also fell in love with me.
Yeah, Ramesh.
And when I'm a married woman, a single man also fell in love with me.
Okay, Ramesh Arvind killed your husband in Amritavarshini.
I know.
To marry you.
Yes.
Now what? Now being the deadly director, killer director that Maniratnam sir is, what is your experience with love?
With love? When you don't expect it, you get love. When you're not expecting, love happens. That is what love is all about. If you dream about it every day and watch movies that talk about love and read, you know, literature which talks about romance, it'll never happen. When you're like busy doing something, probably taking out a thorn from your toe is when love happens. Seriously. That's how unpredictable love is.
Yeah, and
that's how it happened to us.
For me, you have always been an epitome of beauty, grace, talent, and wisdom. When I see you, what comes to my mind is women empowerment and respect. How do you feel about having made such huge impression in our lives?
See, nothing is intended in our lives. I grew up in a small village. I was born as a third girl child to my parents. So when I was born, I'm sure everybody looked at the cradle and said, "Oh my God, another girl." Because my parents, I don't have a brother at all. One brother who was born and he died in 1 month. So there was a lot of sympathies and a lot of people sympathized with my parents as to, oh my God, another girl. I don't think they had that kind of a feeling. They cherished us and they nurtured us. And that's what I think the woman empowerment thing was kind of ingrained in me when I looked, you know, up from my cradle. All these faces, sad faces, because I was a girl. That inspired me to work towards women empowerment.
Okay.
So I was the only girl in my institute, 150 boys. So you can imagine.
So what are the advantages and disadvantages of being a celebrity?
The advantage of being a celebrity is, what is it? I'm trying to see. Yes, people smile at you and they're nice to you. The disadvantage is like, when my husband and I sit quietly for a dinner, there's one man who comes up to us, we're newly married at that time. He comes up to us and asks, "I hope I'm not disturbing you." And before I say anything, my husband says, "You're doing exactly that." I want 5 minutes with my wife. Can you please come later? You know? So these are little problems of being celebrities. But other than that, I don't think so. I'm sure we had a nice talk with that guy also after 5 minutes.
So you were the only female in your batch of cinematography while studying at Madras Film Institute.
That's what I was talking about.
How does that feel? We have heard that film industry is male-dominated one. Did you ever feel discrimination?
No, I was a first person to come into the technical side of film industry. So all of them were so welcoming and all my role models were all men. So it's like, I was like treated like somebody, you know, like their own child, their own sister, their own friend. So all of them were eager to teach me. So I think I was really blessed.
And Sayani Palit, who was one of the speakers in previous IIS, Shankar, she's a Bollywood singer now. Shankar Mahadevan sir has given her a lot of opportunities. We have a lot of actors, writers, singers. Not me. So, do you think you can actually include them in film industry? Right now, I don't seem to know anybody in the film industry who is a person with disability.
I think there's this girl, I forget her name, I'm not able to remember. Sopana Sundari Nandane. Sopana Logatil Tentane. It's sung by a girl who's visually impaired.
Oh, okay.
And I think her name is Vijayalakshmi. Yes. Vaikam Vijayalakshmi. Vijayalakshmi, and she's a fabulous singer. And she'll give a run for all the top singers' money, you know. She's fabulous. And I see her singing in most of the films. And very unusual songs. Very unusual song, which I mean, she's not typecast also, which I think is amazing. And we have a leading director called Dharani who directed Dil. And he's also physically challenged. So these are the fact that you don't even know about it is, I think, wonderful. Because it's not, I mean, they're treated equally in the film industry.
So there's a rapid fire question. Okay, so Nasiruddin Shah or Rekha?
Anytime Rekha. So beautiful. I was a fan of Rekha. My childhood, all my wardrobe was had her photographs. In fact, she gave me a material for me to stitch into a dress. I just looked at it for about 6 months, did not stitch it. By the time I decided to stitch, it was too small for me.
Okay. Cinema theater or home theater?
Cinema theater, anytime. Anytime cinema theater. You know, I think, I don't know about the other state audience. The Tamil audience are like fantastic. It's like an adventure when you go and sit in a cinema theater and watch the movie with them. They are whistling and they have comments and they are clapping. Sometimes the audience is better than the movie.
So, Maniratnam or music? Maniratnam or music?
Why? Why?
It's just a question.
Why are you coming up with questions that are so, so tricky? Why Maniratnam or music? I can have a musical Maniratnam. Actually, between us, he's the one who really loves music. I learnt music, I can sing, but he really listens to wonderful music. In Tamil, we say jnanam for music. I think he has so much of jnanam, and I hope that he starts singing someday.
I think his movies have the best music, always.
That's because he really loves music. Yeah. You
know, and music. Indoors or outdoors?
Indoors.
Okay.
Indoors, yes.
Okay.
I've been out in the sun for too many years, looking at the sun like this way, that way, reflectors looking at us. So indoor is definitely better for me.
So being right or being kind?
Oh my God, my true colors are coming out. What is the spelling of kind? Oh, right, I know. I don't know the spelling of kind. When right comes to me, I forget the spelling of kindness. So forgive me, I think I have to improve my vocabulary and spelling. So,
what do you feel about IIS? What is that one message you want to give us all?
Actually, inclusion is a wonderful word. I mean, I came here and the inclusion is one word that really, you know, attracted me to this whole thing. I run an NGO for single women, and it's not just ability is a problem in the society. Being a single woman is also a huge problem. I have about 250 women with us. And I'll just tell you in a small nutshell, when there is a big festival or a ceremony in their families, they are only informed, they are not invited. So what I did was, when I am invited to light a lamp for a ceremony, I take one of my single women with me and they light the lamp instead of me. I just want to share one thing. There was this girl called Tamil Arasi. I took her for a inauguration of a Satyapal inauguration of a store, and there were all the ladida and the who's who of Chennai, all the women were about 30 of them. So this girl came along with me, she lit the lamp along with me, and they had these interesting snacks and these cool drinks and things like that, which she must have experienced for the first time. So she spent about 1 hour with all of them. They all hugged her, kissed her, and gave her these interesting snacks and gave her gifts and all that. A week later, when I asked her to come and asked her to, you know, tell her experience, talk about her experience to the other women of our NGO, she just said, you know what happened? There were 30 women. Each of them kissed me twice, this side and that side. I was kissed 60 times. I've never been kissed like that in my life. That was the best day of my life. You know? I don't know what I did was right. I'm sure people were really, really kind to her. So, inclusion is wonderful, wonderful. It's really fantastic.
May I request audience to shoot questions?
Okay, we have a question from Ashwin. Okay.
First of all, ma'am, I'm a huge fan of yours and my mom also.
Thank you.
My favorite movie of yours is the one you play with which one where you play a person who cannot speak. How difficult was it to play that character? How did you prepare for it?
Yes, I have played a role of a person who can't hear and also speak in a Telugu film called Sirivennela. That was a very difficult scene because she's a painter, I think. In the film also, she's a painter. And she's asked to explain to another painter who's doing a portrait of the hero. On the stage, they forget that she can't speak. So she starts explaining about him and through gestures, and that was the most difficult scene I've ever done. And when they finish the portrait, it's nothing like the hero, but it looks like something really gorgeous and something so powerful. Because the way she explains, she says, his one eye is the sun, the other eye is the moon. His nose is the flute from which the most divine music comes out, and his lips are like lotus. You know, she starts explaining things like that, even though she can't hear and she can't speak. And then there was this portrait of him, which was like gorgeous. So that was really difficult and something that happened also on the sets. We didn't plan it in such a way to rehearse or do something different, but it happened. So that's my favorite scene.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. One more question. Anybody who has a question? I see one person jumping out of his seat. Okay, now I have to run. Yes.
Very good afternoon. Ma'am, first time I want to ask you one thing. Like, when you act as a mother in a film, how you feel that experience? Like, to an actor like Allu Arjun or...
Yash.
Yash. Anything. Anything or Jayam Ravi also. If you act as a mother, how you feel that experience?
When I acted as a wife to Nageshwar Rao. When I acted as wife to Shobhan Babu. And when I acted as a wife to Krishnam Raju, same thing. Director tells me he's your husband, he's my husband. Director tells me he's your grandson, he's my grandson. No problem. I'm very obedient. That's it.
Ma'am, I have one question from my side here. You shared this beautiful story of how the restaurant was named during the breakfast today. Would you share that with the audience? Because I thought it was so profound.
Okay. You know, things happen for a reason. Nothing happens without a reason.
Magic happens at India Inclusion Summit. Magic happens.
Yes, magic happens. Yes, really. On the way to this summit, when we were coming, something really wonderful happened. I got my national award because of director K. Balachandar, who made my uncle also a great actor, you know. I took some time to act in his film, but there's one film that he directed of mine called Manadil Urudhi Vendum, where I play a nurse. That particular role has been a role model to many people, including a woman who was fighting a case, defamation case that I had. So, she told me, the people tried to stop her from filing my case at the right time, but she jumped out of the window and filed it. And she said, I took inspiration from the role Nandini that you played, the nurse Nandini that you played in Manadil Urudhi Vendum. She's not the first person. At least about 10 to 15 people have told me that that film has changed their lives. Okay, that was about, I'm talking about 20 years ago or 10 years ago. Recently, I got a forward from a friend of mine saying that a man was inspired by the role, Nandini, because his life was very similar. So when he was looking after his siblings and finally when he decided to do something of his life, out of his life after looking after them, he started a chain of restaurants and he wanted to name those restaurants Nandini after Manadil Urudhi Vendum. So this was about 6 to 8 months ago. Or even 1 year ago, somebody sent me this clipping and I showed it to his daughter because K. Balachandar is no more. In the first anniversary, I showed it to her and she was quite happy and touched by it. And as we were coming, before we got into the hotel here yesterday, we stopped at 2-3 restaurants to have food. And then we finally found one and we didn't even notice the name. It was called Nandana. And once I sat there and started eating, I told my dear friend Ranjini, who's responsible for me coming here, Ranjini Manian. Thank you, Ranjini, for bringing me here. I was telling her, you know, there is a great story about this restaurant. The whole chain was named after a character that I had done. I was so touched. And the manager of the hotel came and said, Madam, we're very happy that you have come here. And I said, I'm glad that I have come here also. I know about the naming of the restaurant. And he said, our MD happens to be here by chance. So can he meet you? And I said, please, I want to meet him. And he came and he chatted and he said, it's only because of your film and the role that I started these chain of restaurants, Nandini and Nandana. And I took a photograph with him yesterday.
Amazing.
Thanks to Heroes.
Amazing. Thank you. Do you guys really believe now that magic happens at IIS?
Yes, magic happens.
Yeah? Thank you, ma'am. I think there's a beautiful saying that we are all actors in a series of coincidences, right? Thank you.
Okay, so I'm not going to leave you. Your song is still pending.
Yes.
Yes, you heard it right.
What, can I sing a Tamil song? Is that okay? Since she talked about my husband, can I sing a song from his film?
Yes, definitely.
Paruvame, if all of you are ready to come here and jog, then I'll sing that song. I think there's not enough place. Paruvame, pudiya paadal paadu. Oh, she's getting goose flesh. Okay, I'm going to sing a song from my husband's film, which introduced us to A.R. Rahman.
Wow.
Chinna chinna asai. சீரகடிக்கும் ஆசை முத்து முத்து ஆசை முடிந்து வைத்த ஆசை வெண்ணிலவு தொட்டு முத்தமிட ஆசை என்னை இந்த பூமி சுற்றி வராசை சின்ன சின்ன ஆசை சீரகடிக்கும் ஆசை மல்லிகை பூவாய் மாறிவிட ஆசை தென்றலை கண்டு மாலையிட ஆசை மேகங்களை எல்லாம் தொட்டுவிட ஆசை சோகங்களை எல்லாம் விட்டுவிட ஆசை கார்
குழலில் உழகை கட்டிவிடாசை சின்ன சின்ன ஆசை சிறகடிக்கும் ஆசை முத்து முத்து ஆசை முடிந்து வைத்த ஆசை.
What an inspiring afternoon it was.
Thank you so much.
A huge round of applause.